Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Jeff Space Program. It's super early in the morning, but I don't get no damn fucks, because I'm excited. I'm having fun building space parts. And today we're going to be doing a... I do have a revision to make. I said we were going to do a science module and a communications module, but I'm not going to do that. I'm going to combine those two into one, and then I'm going to make a refueling depot. So, this time we're going to be working on the science and communications module. The reason that I want to do a science and communications module is because the communications module consists of this and this. There we go. We're done. It's not exactly requiring of its own module. So, we're going to have the science and comm all set up into one module. And the cool thing about this module is that it doesn't need to be very big. It can be very small. And I want to find a way to incorporate some of these things, these little wiry node bastard guys. And I want to put, like, a cool, I don't know, thing on it to make it look scientific-er. You know what I'm talking about. So, I think what I'm going to do is we're going to make science stuff happen. It's going to need power. It's going to need juice. It's going to need to fly. So, I'm going to design a little science module, just the tip. God, I keep saying that. It's so not cool. Stop it, me. And then we're going to make a rocket for it to shoot into space on. Here is the JSS for science. And I put some pylons on here, which hold external communications and scientific research thingies. We've got batteries. We've got... I forgot to put collector thingies on it, but we'll get that taken care of. Anyway, it has communications short and long, it's got an accelerometer, a barometer here, a thermodynamometer, and a ravioli detector, in case we come across Space Italy. We will be able to detect it and identify it. And I do want to actually really, really, really consider putting on one of these guys, or at least one, maybe two. Also got avionics packages nestled away in there. Where am I going to put these? There's no room for these. I just want two of them. Just put them on top of the batteries? No, that's not going to work. I guess we could put them right there. Those things are really heavy, though, I think. No, they're not that heavy. No, I don't know what it was that was causing my other spaceship to weigh itself down so much. I don't really like that. I like having these arrays, the instruments arrayed as relatively far apart. I guess I could put them up straight on the battery right here. Yeah, that'll work. Coolo! Now, this thing is going to be heavy and tough as shit to maneuver. I added a little bit of extra RCS tanks to it. But, yeah, we've got all of the scientific equipment that we need. And a little bit of extra, and some communication stuff, and a little bit of extra RCS fuel. I put on some extra thrusters, because I just know that this thing's going to be a beast to maneuver out in the cold, hard depths of space. And now we just got to find a way to get this thing up there. So I think it's going to be a fairly standard, at this point, extremely standard asparagus stock system launching this fellow into space. I know it's kind of boring, but, you know, when you've got something that works, why fuck with it? It works. There's a reason that it works. And that reason is pew-pew lasers or something. I don't think this is going to be enough. I think we want to have a small intermediary stage hereabouts. Actually, that would be this engine. This is going to be a relatively large-ish rocket, but it's for the greater good. And we'll have our stock system down here. Wait a minute. I think I might have forgotten. No, I put an engine on that. It's just one of the small ones. That's right. There we go. And then from here, I'll stock this out. And hopefully this guy will find a way to fly. We're going to need to secure these things down with some space tape. But this should be an interesting one to fly. I'll put it that way. I like it. It's strapping. And looks sort of menacing in a weird kind of way. It looks like something that you would launch into an enemy country in the hopes that it would do some shrapnel damage or something like that. It certainly does not look all that viable, but I guess we're gonna find out. Hey, it's very bright over there for some reason. Seems good to me. I guess I'll be back when we're either in space or not. We're doing our orbital burn now, and I already planned a maneuver that should, in theory, intersect me with the Jeff International Space Station. I still need to rename that. What's really odd is that this has so far been the most stable of any of the modules that we've launched, which is very strange. The issue that I have right now is that I have gone to this smaller engine, and I don't know if it's got enough thrust to achieve the kind of maneuver that we need to do, because look, this is taking way too long. We're going to be down here by the time this maneuver happens. We were supposed to maneuver our maneuver right there, so I don't think this maneuver really applies. So I'm going to go ahead and get rid of that. we'll deal with maneuvering later. For now, I just want to see if we can get this fucking thing into orbit. Yeah, I don't think that... If this does happen, it's not going to happen in a very positive way. I think I need to replace this engine with a slightly thrustier model. Because we still do have this engine right here for the capture and maneuver stage. So, I don't really know why I did this. I guess I just assumed that we would have enough fuel in the asparagus system to get us into orbit. And normally we do, but I guess this module is a bit heavier than I was expecting. So I think I'm going to fix that. Alright, we're pretty close, so I'm going to do a proximity burn in the hopes that... I can get closer. Although, that thing is going pretty fast, so I don't know. I guess we're just going to hope for the best. It's also going this way. I don't know if we're close enough to do a eyeball burn. This thing's very weird to maneuver out here in space. Okay, we're sort of heading towards it now. Yeah, I'm going to hope that we can just sort of walk it in from here, but we don't have a lot of fuel left, actually. We had to use a lot for the burns to get it just to be close, so I don't know. It's going to be touch and go for a bit here. I might smack into it. That'd be pretty horrible. Getting warmer! Still kind of far away and probably gonna pass me really fast, but oh well. We'll see. Alright, we switched over to RCS and are approaching now. Well, it's sort of approaching us, I guess. But I think we're gonna go ahead and smack into it relatively easily. Just a matter of how hard and at what part. Here is the glorious bastard. You can see it from 100 meters away. Well, you can see it clearly from 100 meters away, which is pretty impressive. And now we're going to go poke it in the docking portion, hopefully. Hopefully this one will be relatively easy. I do have two headlights on the front here. I'll turn them on for easier docking manoeuvres. And I think I see a port. It's a little tough for me to tell from here. Oh, I did want to notice, I didn't mention this in the design phase, I left a crew module on here. It doesn't have anybody in it, but I left it so that the science section could be manned if needs be, because I didn't know how any of this equipment worked. But I think we're going to be good. We're actually approaching this from the habitation module side. We're going to need to swing around this way in order to orient ourselves properly. I don't really like the orientation of that thing. I might want to change it. Oh, that's not good. I'm going to smack into it. No? Okay, we're good. that was fun. I think we're going to dock with this one. We'll set that as our target. Opposite of the power wing. Yeah, this is going to be weird. Apparently I'm going to have to do this sideways. It also looks like it's sort of rotating a bit. None of which is good. But we'll get ourselves in a position. I think I can change the camera. Yeah. Oh, no. Well, maybe. Yeah, this could work. It's not doing that funky make me vomit cam, so that's good. Yeah, this can work. I can see this working. Okay. Goal sighted, although I can't really get a good view of the front of it, but, you know, we'll be okay. Alright. This is much easier without an SAS, I think. Oops, I want to go the other way. Oh, I gotta be upside down, camera. Why you gotta be everything but the one I want? Okay, that'll that's perfect. Perfecta. Good. Man, we're getting good at this. I just gotta get it on the right altitude. Oh, yeah. Oh, man. We'll just walk it in now. Easy pie. Slightly. It's too easy. How is this? It shouldn't be this easy. This is supposed to be insanely difficult. It's been insanely difficult in the past. Every single time. Without fail. If I can just one-shot this, just click, boom, like Legos, man, I'd be all over that opportunity. Get in there. Yes! Oh, man. We are scientific and shit. Now we have communication modules and sensors and power thingamajiggers. These other two are going to be a bit difficult to dock with because of the nature of the habitation module. But let me see here. Can I turn on all of the lights? There we go. That makes it a little bit brighter. We need some external lighting up in this bitch. So we have our antennas here. I can toggle those on. Oh, that's cool! Oh my god! I didn't know they would do that. That is dope as heck. Toggle. Oh, yeah, girl. Turn on all of the sensors. Well, the accelerometer's value is zero because I guess we're not accelerating, and that's fine. Can I turn on... What's that? What is that? Did I put something there? No, that was just one of the attachments thing. Oh, yeah, I can turn that antenna on, too. Hell, yeah. Dude. Science and communications. Alright, let's turn this guy on. Does he animate? No, but it does give me... We are going at 0.26 meters per second, upper bracket 2. I need that. The temperature is negative 201.63 degrees. And we are in a vacuum. I am shocked. For one, I am shocked. Awesome, so now we have a science and communications array here. Is it just me, or does that look fucking sweet? That's been a lot of work to get all this up here. I kind of want to flip it over, though. Like, I think it's upside down right now. I don't know if that's going to do me any favors. If I just leave it like this, it'll rotate around, and then it'll be right side up. So today, we're going to be making a fuel depot, why can't I move my, I have to pick one of these first. Well, it's going to be unmanned. We'll go with this again. We don't need it to be a manned fuel po. And I actually need to do a little research because I have theories about how we could make this work. And that would be something like this. If I were to add, like, a coupler here, and then add, say, just for, you know, the sake of shoop-de-whoop, 2 fuel tanks, and then put a docking thing on this end of it, we would be able to dock with it and then remove it. But I don't know if this is crossfeed capable. It is crossfeed capable. Okay, so in theory, all we'd need to do would be to have a ship that could dock with this and then fly away. But there's all sorts of other issues, because how do you dock with the tip, or do you dock with a fuel grabber, or, you know, what do you do? How do you do that? I don't know. So I'm gonna do a little bit of reading. I'm gonna check out the forums and see if I can find something about that. Alright, from what I understand, you don't actually have to take the fuel pods with you. You can just drain fuel from them using the feeding. the crossfeeding. You can use Alt-Right-Click to do in and out stuff. I don't know, I haven't done it, but I think that's what we're going to operate on the assumption of. Now, the problem that we have is that we're going to need to be a little bit weird about how we design this, because I don't necessarily want to have it be a straight up, you know, like, lengthwise connector. I don't want to have, like, fuel pod, and then a dock down here. I'm thinking, because these structures are cross-feed capable, these ones here, I think what we might want to do is extend our tanks out a little bit, like this, so that they're not directly touching. And then what I can do is add something like, where is it? Where to go? Where do you live? Where are you? Something like this in between, so that we could have a ship that would dock here and take the fuel out of these two pods. But I also kind of want to see if we can maybe get a huge one up there, because these two carry together. Let's see here. How much fuel do we have? Maybe 360 liquid fuel. This one carries 720, so this one tank, well, doubles that. The obvious problem is that it's frickin' huge. Let's see here. Yeah, we'd need something like this to adapt it. It's not that big. It's pretty big. It's fucking huge. Let's just put that out there. We could put one of these extenders on here to make it a little bit more manageable. But then how would we have something dock? We wouldn't really need something to dock with this, because this would, in and of itself, be able to feed through this into the rest of the station. So all you'd really need to do is dock with another portion of the station. So I think that's what we're going to operate with. The less we have on here, the better. It's going to be hard enough to take this thing up there as is. I don't know if we want to add maybe like a huge RCS thing to this. This is huge. It's fucking massive. This is a massive 9, massive 1.4. I don't think we need that much. Well, we might. We very well might. Yeah, I guess we'll go with that for now. We can change our happy little minds later, but we're going to operate with a lot of RCS thrusters on this thing. There's 4, and we'll put 4 more on the actual fuel tank itself. So, because we're going to need any and all maneuverability, stopping power, and etc. once we've got this thing up there. But now for the fun part, getting it up there. wait, is this nose cone cross-feed capable? Yeah, it is. Okay, so everything in here is feed capable. Even the docking thing should be. Yeah, they are. All we gotta do is hope that this thing is. It's cross-feed capable. Alright, so everything's cross-feed capable. And we just gotta hope that none of the other portions of the space station that I've used will block this fuel thingy. And we gotta find a way to get this up there without using it. That's a lot of fuel that will allow for a lot of refueling. And then I suppose later we can always refuel this by sending up more missions. But for now, we just want to get this thing up there. Ooh, wait a minute. How is my... I think we're going to connect this opposite the... opposite the habitation module. So what we'll do instead of this, then, is we'll add a docking port on the side of it. It's going to be very difficult to dock. In fact, I think I'm going to... No, I don't think that's necessary. Yeah, we're going to add it like this, opposite the... Oh, man. That would be really asymmetrical and really weird. No, I think we'll go with the original plan. I don't want to fuck with this too much. It's already going to be weird. Let's not weird it up even more. It's going to be... I don't want to think about this too much, because this might not even be possible. ISS Fuel Depot. Now we got to find a way to get this fucker up there. And we're going to need some really, really big... I think we're going to need... a massive asparagus system. We're going to need a lot of these. Okay, so let's go ahead and add a huge coupler here. And a huge SAS here, please. And then we can start putting on massive Rocco thingies. Actually, no. We're going to put that and then a smaller engine, something like this. Yeah, there we go. That'll be our maneuverability engine thingamajigger. And then we'll add another coupler, and then we can go with the huge. So yeah, this is going to be an asparagus of these gigantic orange things. Which should be pretty crazy, especially because these engines are fucking dangerous. I had just one of these before, and it was nearly explosive, so I don't really know how having a lot more than one of them is going to handle it. I don't know, but I'm going to find out, you know, for science. And for the awesome. Holy crap, if that can't get that thing up there, then fuck it. that's my theory. It can't be done. Alright, now I'm going to rig this guy up. We'll need some big-ass cones on here just to make it look swanky and smooth. Hey. Be more than one of you. Thank you. Man, that looks like a sweet-ass fucking ice cream cone. Sherbet with cream. Yum! Alright, I'm going to wire it up. What's nice about this is that it's very, very, very simple. It's just boom, 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 and then dock. So, I guess we're going to find out how quickly the boom booms happen, because these engines are prone to overheating, and I don't know how this is going to go. Okay, whoa, it's very heavy. It's very, very heavy, but they're not overheating yet, so that's good. These are relatively close together. Oh, doob-doob. Alright, that's fine. I can keep it at this throttle. I don't think the overheating is going to be that much of a problem, as long as they don't interfere with each other and create extra overheating. Now, the separation here could be weird, because these are awful big. And very spinny. I always love it when it gets to this stage. It just looks the coolest right here. So yeah, I think everything's good. I will see you in space, or near it, or far from it. I don't know. Guess who forgot to put a battery and a solar power thing? It's me! Alright, so we've spotted the station, and it's getting further away from me. That's not good. I'm trying to get close to it, but it's a bit of a hassle. This thing is gigantic and heavy. I actually had to jettison my primary burn tank a little early because it had too much fuel in it. So I think we might have even been able to put more fuel up here, but that's not really what we're going for. We want what we need, not what we want. Wait a minute, that doesn't even make... Wow, that's a whole new level of dumb right there. Oh, me. Yeah, we're gonna smack into this thing hopefully sometime soon, if I don't lose control of my spaceship. Apparently I've lost control. So that's fun. Which way is left? Left is to my left. Right is also to my left. That does not seem proper. But who am I to argue with the physics of Kerbal Space Program? Who am I? Alright. We're going to be coasting closer and closer and closer, and hopefully we'll get there soon. Okay, we are coming in here, and this is really difficult to control. Something about the RCS thrusters on this thing is making it so that I can't quite move or turn this without it going crazy. And we're trying to do this in the middle of the night, which is also not the best idea. I do have headlights on this thing, but they appear to be extremely short-ranged. I can't even quite tell exactly how we are in relation to the ship. Station thingy. Okay, I think I know. Alrighty. Let's slow it down a peg. And we'll let it pass by us a little bit so we can see how we want to dock this. I think it'd be fine for me to dock it in between the power panel and the science wing, I believe. And I like that because that would leave the habitation module as our shuttle docking point, which is fine because I don't really like the idea of... Oh, goodness, this thing is wild. It controls very, very strangely. I don't really like the idea of docking inside this thing unless we absolutely have to. So I'd prefer it if we could get this docked to... Oh, there's no docking port right there. Dang it. That's a problem. That is a problem. I suppose I probably should have thought of that when I was building that first station ship thingy. Well, I guess we'll dock on top then. We can dock here or on the bottom, but I think we're going to dock here. And come on, go get closer. This is, once again, a monumental pain in the dick, because if I do any of the controls for this, it seems to try to do all of them at once. Oh, it's going to make me puke. Can we just settle down? Can we just be cool? Okay, I'm going to turn on fine controls. I think we're... Oh, goodness. Slow down! Slow down! That is not the docking port. Oh, no, we hit it. Oh, no, 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 no. Let's turn on SAS real quick. All right. Turn on RCS. Okay, that should have stopped the rotation of the space station for now. Now we just got to deal with our own problems. Please go like that, and then we need to shift with this way. Yeah, this camera's not going to work. I can't see where I'm headed. Okay, this one will work. This one will work fine. We need to get ourselves oriented somehow. This way. Is that touching? No, it's not. And we need to reorient, but that's okay. We can do it, we can do it, we can do it. Yeah. Okay. What am I doing? I need to go left. And... Oh, we're not at the right angle. I can't really see very easily. Oh, that's the wrong way. Okay, that's looking good. I think. Yeah, that's looking good. Oh, God, and I'm always getting left and right backwards. I don't know why. It makes relatively a decent amount of sense. But for some reason, I just always get left and right backwards. Is that lined up pretty well? Oh, be careful. Oh, what is gonna happen? Oh, I'm nervous. This thing's so heavy. Uh-oh. Oh my God, that was so fucking scary. I thought it was gonna, like, collapse on itself. Holy crap. Okay, so, this pod steer here still actually has fuel. Let me, supposedly alt right click and... Oh, transfer in. Oh, hey, look, I'm refueling this one from this one. Dope. All right, now transfer back into this one. Okay, and don't we have another rocket on here somewhere? Yeah, we got this guy right here. What's his fuel looking like? He's got a little bit. So if I alt-right-click you, and then I alt-right-click you, I can suck all of the fuel that's left from this into here. I don't know if that completed the process. It didn't. There we go. We stole all of its fuel and oxidizer, or most of its fuel and oxidizer. Do we have another... This thing's not quite empty, but whatever. So now, if anything docks with any portion of this station, preferably right here, because you can't dock here. Oh, this would be a safe place to dock, too. We could totally jettison this engine and this tank right here, but it's got fuel in it, so I don't think we'll jettison it until we take the fuel out of it. It has a coupler, so we're not concerned about that. And our station just got... It actually pretty much, like, quadrupled in mass and definitely nearly doubled in size from that refueling depot. Jebediah's like, hells yeah, I got the fuel now. I got all kinds of fuel. Let's have Jeb go out and on a walkabout now. I want him to go to the science module. I haven't had anybody in the science module ever. It's right here. Let's turn his lights on. Whoop. I need to get Jeb some buddies up here to play with, too. Whoop. Cool. Now he's living in the science module. And you can press buttons, and please stop pressing that particular button. In fact, it's kind of scary. I don't know how well this is going to work out, because every time I put a Kerbin in and out of this thing, it turns on SAS, and eventually there's going to be so much SAS on this that it's just going to shake itself to pieces. But still, I would like to ride this guy around. This is a very large thing. There is... What we're at right now is the point where there is no way you could build a rocket that would get this into orbit. But here it is. I'm loving it. Oh, I've got some fuel depot debris. No, my depot. But I can just kill this. It doesn't have any docking ports on it, so there's no way I could safely deorbit it. I suppose that might be something I should look into in the future, is if I have a stage that I know is going to be left in orbit, I can have a dedicated deorbiter and then, you know, put a docking port on that thing and then go out and get it, but I'm not really concerned about that. All right, so we'll end this flight, go back to the tracking station. Let's take a look again at our space station. I want to rename this, if I can. It's named the Habitation Station. Let's rename this. Yeah. The JSS Space Station. Station, yeah. And now, if we look here, there it is, the JSS Space Station. And it is certainly that. Oh, whoa, the panels are all wonky. That's cool. I like that. All right, so we've got one more dock on our hub to fill. We've got science, power, fuel. I'm thinking that this could just be our shuttle dock, although we also have this thing here. I think that this would be better for the shuttle dock because it's not... You don't have to dock anywhere near any other kind of debris or weirdness. But we can expand and add another section onto this Clampotron. Or we could expand and add another section onto this Clampotron. We could even add another hub on here and make this thing kaboom boom. In fact, I might want to have a nice big long hub. Or, I mean, a bunch of these pylons go out of here and go far away from the rest of it to create an expanded module that's a decent distance away. I don't really know what the purpose of that would be, except that it would be kind of awesome. So I'm going to EVA Jeb from his science station. And let's see, where... I don't really know. I mean, so far we've had Jeb mostly living in the three-man... cockpit thingy for the habitation module, but there's really no reason for him to be in there. I guess the habitation module would probably be best, you know, so he can habitate. I wonder if you can IVA... No, you can't IVA when they're in the habitation module. There's no inside for that. But everything looks good for the rest of the ship and the station. It's everything's humming. We got us an operation here. I guess we'll put him back in his cockpit, you know. He needs to be somewhere where he can do some damage. That's Jeb. and he's still happy up here, even though he hasn't got a chance to rocket blow up anything in a while. But there it is. There's our fuel depot with a a very large fuel tank and a little extra right here for any intrepid space explorer to hop over and refuel their ship and get a little bit of extra fuel for the ride. So that expands our exploration options pretty dramatically. With me! What of me?